Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how to use forms in Numbers on your iPhone or iPad. So usually when we talk about apps like Numbers, there are more features on the Mac version than on the iPhone or iPad version. But there's one really cool feature of Numbers that's only available on the iPhone and iPad, and that's forms. The ability to add and edit data in a Numbers table using a form that shows you one row at a time. So I'm going to use the iPhone here to demonstrate, but it works the same way on the iPad. I'm going to go into the Numbers app and let's create a brand new spreadsheet here. And let's just create something really simple to keep track of expenses. So maybe this first column here, I'll just make this the date. And then I'll add some other columns for other things. So I'll just have one column here where we describe the expense, another that's the amount, then a category for each expense, and then some notes. Let's go here and get rid of the extra column. So we just have what we need there. And then let's name this table expenses. Now you can see the problem here on the iPhone. This is all pretty small. If I want to enter in data here, I've got to double click here on this field and then enter in each individual thing. It would be great if there was a way that I could zoom in on this. And I can, but now I'm scrolling across to see each one. A better way to do it is to just focus on the one row, the one expense at a time. And that's exactly what Forms does. So a form is another kind of page in Numbers. Usually you've got sheets and you can create multiple sheets. Each can hold multiple tables. But if I tap the plus button here, I can add a new sheet, but I could also add a new form. Then it presents me with some choices. I can create a blank form, but in this case, I already have a table that I want to use with this form. So I'm going to look here and it's going to list all the tables. I just have one sheet and one table in that sheet, but if I had multiple sheets and multiple tables, it would list them all. The expenses table is what I want to use. So I'm going to select that. And now I can see at the top, I've got sheet one and then expenses form. And here is the form. And you could see each column of the expenses table, date, expense, amount, category, and notes. And I could enter data by simply tapping on each one and then typing the data. So for instance, I could type, say, January 31st here. I could put the name of an expense, like let's say rent. I can enter an amount and I can enter a category like that. Now I can click done there at the top and I could see the whole thing. If I go back to sheet one, note that the data in this table has been updated to include the data I entered in the form. The form is just another way of accessing the data in this table. It's actually the same data, just viewed in two different ways. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. Now let's improve on this sum. First, let's get rid of all the blank rows here. So I'm going to get rid of all of those. So I just have this one line of data. Then I'm going to go to each column and I'm going to set a good format for it. So I'm going to double click on A here and it's going to select all of the cells except for the header cell in A. And I'm going to use the paintbrush button there. And now I'm going to go to format here at the bottom and I'm going to set the format to date and time. I could tap the I button here and I could pick a format. Let's do that. I'm going to pick this format right here. You can pick whichever one you want. And then I'm going to do the same thing here for column B. This time though, I'm going to format with text. So I'm just going to allow text entry here. Let's go to C and I'm going to format this as currency. So a number value, and I'm going to use a thousand separator, counting style, two decimal places, and US dollars here. Category here, I'm going to also set that one to text. So I could type whatever it is I want. And the same thing here for notes. I'm going to make that text. So now when I go to the expenses form, you can see the data there from the first row. There's a plus button here to add another entry. So I'm going to add another entry. When I tap here on date, notice how the keyboard at the bottom reflects the data format. So I just have numbers and a slash, things like AM, PM, and all of that, things that have to do with the date. There's also a handy little today button. I'm going to use that. And it enters in that date. This is plain text. So I enter in what I want here. And then when I go to amount, you could see it just gives me numbers. So I could enter in the amount like that. And then category is back to text. And then done. And now I can see this data here. Now that I've got two entries, I can use the back button here to go back to item one of two, or the first row, and the forward button now to go to two of two, the second row. So I can actually go through the data in my table with these arrows. I don't have to view it in the regular table format. I can always use the form here. I can use the trash or bin button here to delete an entry and the plus button to add a new one. I can, of course, just switch back to this sheet to go back to the table. But if this is a more complex spreadsheet with many sheets and many tables, I can use this handy button here to go directly to the table that this form represents. Now let's go make this even better. For category, instead of typing, I want to be able to just choose a category. So I'm going to double click here on the header to select all of the value cells here, go back to format. And instead of text, which is what we set this to, I'm going to set it to pop-up menu. And when we do, it's going to look at the values there so far and add them in. So housing and utility. I can add a new one, like for instance, clothing. And let's add another one for entertainment. So now that I've set the format to be pop-up, when I go back to the form here, I go to category and tap on it. Instead of being able to enter text, I now can select from this list here. You could do the same thing with other columns. For instance, let's add a column here and call this one priority. And then we're going to double click here on the heading to select it all. And I'm going to set the format here to a star rating. But I could also choose things like checkbox. I could choose stepper to step through values, or a slider to have a slider to choose like a value from 1 to 100 or 1 to 1,000, that kind of thing. Now when I go to the form here, notice I've got the stars and I could just tap it to choose. Also note that you could set a lot of these things like formatting up here in the forms interface rather than in the regular sheet interface. This button here, you tap that and I could see each of the items here. So for instance, I can go into date, tap I, and then I could choose the format there just like I did with the table. The same thing with other things like here's priority and it's set to star rating. You can also reorder things. So I can move priority up right after amount like that and then tap done. If I go back to the sheet, notice how it has changed the order of the columns to match the form. Also back here in the form, if I go into settings, I can add a new field. That comes in handy if you tap the plus button and create a new form and just decide to create a completely blank form. You can see how you get to the same place here. It gives you three sample fields. You could go in here and change the name. You can change the format in here. You can drag these around and reorder them. And because I created a new form that wasn't linked to a previous table, notice I've got the form, and I also have a new sheet called form data where it created the table, and that table is linked to the form. Oh, and if you're wondering what it looks like when you open up that same spreadsheet in the Mac version of Numbers, well, you simply see the regular sheets. The forms just aren't there. All of your data is there because every form has to be linked to a table in a sheet, which you can access in Numbers on your Mac. You just can't access that data in a form format. So if you ever need to use spreadsheets on your iPhone, give forms a try to make things easier for you. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.